Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. Good morning. So today I'm going to present about my final project proposal, which is cost of production calculation analysis full costing method of CV Mitra Dunia Palitindo or MD Carton Box. This presentation is carried out by me, Haya Nabila Febriana, from AK3F, from Accounting Study Program, Accounting Major, Semarang State Polytechnic 2022. And here are the table of contents that we will explain. The first one is about Chapter 1, which is introduction, including the search of background, formulation of the program, the research purpose, the benefit of research, the scope of research, and the last one is the writing system. And for the Chapter 2, is the literature review, including definition of cost accounting, definition of cost, classification of cost, definition of cost of goods sold, and the elements of cost of goods sold, the methods of cost of goods sold, the concept of selling price, and the last one is the theoretical framework. And for the last one is Chapter 3. It is about research method, including definition of research method, the classification of the data, data collection technique, data analysis technique, and the last one is the schedule of the activities. And we are going to explain about the introduction. From the research background, according to Bustami and Nurlela, the cost of production is a collection of production costs consisting of direct raw materials, direct labor costs, and factory overhead costs, plus inventories of products in the initial process and less inventories of products in the final process. Another opinion was put forward by Mulyadi, which explains that the cost of production is all costs incurred to produce an item for service during the period concerned. From the two definitions, it can be concluded that the cost of production is all costs incurred by the company to produce or produce a finished product. Determination of the cost of production at CV Mitra Dunia Palitindo, which is located in the Candi Industrial Estate, Gatot Subroto, Block 19, Number 19 Block, District Ngalian, Semarang City, comes from the accumulated cost of raw materials, both main raw materials and auxiliary raw materials, as well as labor costs in the production department. The various types of raw materials for each product produced certainly require more detailed calculation regarding the cost components involved in order to obtain accurate production data. Therefore, based on the background described, it is necessary to conduct research on the calculation on the cost of production at CV Mitra Dunia Palitindo to take into account in detail all costs incurred in the production process in order to obtain a competitive selling price. And the next is the formulation of the problem. Based on the background that has been described previously, the problems raised in the study are as follows. The first one is, how is the cost of production effective in determining the selling price on CV Mitra Dunia Palitindo? And the second is, how to make the right decision regarding the result of the calculation of the cost production using the full costing method with the calculation method applied by CV Mitra Dunia Palitindo? And for the research purpose, the objectives in this research are as follows. The first one is calculating the cost of production at CV Mitra Dunia Palitindo using the full costing method. And the second is assessing the accuracy and effectiveness of the calculation of the cost of productions applied by CV Mitra Dunia Palitindo. And the third is provide solutions or recommendation to CV Mitra Dunia Palitindo regarding the correct calculation of the cost of production related to making decision to determine the selling of the product. And for the benefits of the research, these are as follows. The first one is association and input in calculating the cost of production that can be used as a basis for making decision to determine the selling price of CV Mitra Dunia Palitindo products. And the second is adding insight and deepening understanding of the application of the calculation of the cost of production as the basis for determining the selling price of the products. And the third, as a reference for the preparation of research, especially related to the calculation of the cost of production as the basis of determining the selling price of the product. For the scope of research, the scope of this research is limited to the calculation of the cost of production of box furniture, box garments, and box accessories at CV Mitra Dunia Palitindo. And for the writing system, the systematic of writing is a description of the contents of a structured research proposal on the issues raised. The following is a systematic writing of the research. The first one is Chapter 1 or Introduction. Chapter 1 it contains the background of the problem, problem formulation, research objectives, benefit of research, scope of research, and systematic of research writing. And the second is Chapter 2 or Literature Review. Chapter 2 explains the theoretical foundation of the definition of cost accounting, the definition of cost, the calculation of cost, the definition of the cost of production, the elements of the cost of production, the method of determining the cost of production, and the determination of the selling price. And for the last is Chapter 3, which is research method. Chapter 3 describes the meaning of research method, data classification, data collection techniques, data analysis techniques, and research activity schedule. Okay, let's move on to the Chapter 2, which is literature review. The first one is a definition of cost accounting. According to Mulyadi, cost accounting is the process of recording, classifying, summarizing, and presenting the cost of making and selling products or services in certain ways and interpreting them. Cost accounting as a source of information from all expenses made by the company, which is then used in assisting decision-making related to the management of the company itself. The second is the definition of cost. Mulyadi argues that costs are sacrifice of economic resources measured in units of money that have occurred or are likely to occur for certain purposes. Based on this definition, there are four elements related to cost. Namely, the first one is cost is an economic sacrifice. The second, measured in units of money. The third, what has happened or is potentially going to happen. And the last is the sacrifice for a specific purpose. The third is classification of cost. Mulyadi classifies cost into five groups based on the first is the object of expenditure, the second is the main function in the company, and for the second is cost according to the main function are divided into three groups, namely production cost, the second marketing cost, and the last one is general administration fee. The third is the relationship of cost with something that is financed. Mulyadi classifies cost according to the relationship between cost and something being financed into two groups, namely direct cost, and the second is indirect cost. The fourth Behavior, of course, in relation to changes in the volume of activity. The classification, of course, according to this basis, is classified into variable cost, semi-variable cost, semi-fixed cost, and last is fixed cost. And the five is period of benefit. Based on the period of benefit, costs are divided into two. The first one is capital expenditure and expenditure of income or revenue expenditure. Move to the next is definition of cost of goods sold. Quoting from Hansen and Moen, the cost of production is the assignment of costs that support specific managerial goals, where all the cost components involved in the production process are referred to as production cost or production cost or manufacturing cost. And the purpose of calculating the cost of production is to ensure and evaluate the effectiveness of the product selling price set by the company itself. The formulation of the three cost components is as follows. HPP is the calculation of BBB plus PTKL plus BOP. The description is HPP is cost of production, BBB is raw material cost, PTKL is direct labor cost, and BOP is factory overhead cost. The elements of cost of goods sold including the costs incurred in the production process, which are the cost of raw materials and the direct labor cost. The classification of labor costs can be described as follows. The first is according to the main function in the company organization. Below are examples of labor costs based on each main function. The first is production labor cost, second is marketing labor cost, the third is administrative and general labor cost. Second, according to the activities of departments or sections within the company. The third is according to product relationship. And the third component of the cost is factory overhead cost, including the cost of auxiliary materials, second, repair and maintenance costs, indirect labor costs, and the fourth is costs incurred as a result of the valuation of fixed assets. And the fifth is costs incurred as a result of the passage of time. In addition to the above classification, factory overhead costs can also be classified based on the relationship to the volume or activity. The three types of factory overhead costs are as follows. The first one is fixed factory overhead cost, second is variable factory overhead cost, and the third is semi-variable factory overhead cost. And the methods of the cost of goods sold are based on Mulyadi that there are two methods in determining the cost of production, namely the full costing method and the variable costing method. The full costing method is a method of determining the cost of production consisting of raw material costs, direct labor costs, and factory overhead costs, both fixed and variable. Based on the description before, the following is the calculation of the cost of production based on the full costing method. It is the calculation of raw material costs, direct labor costs, fixed factory overhead, and variable factory overhead, which is result in cost of production. The second is variable costing. According to Mulyadi, the variable costing method is a method of determining the cost of production that takes into account variable production costs into the cost of production consisting of raw material costs, direct labor costs, and variable factory overhead costs. From the explanation above, the following is a report on the cost of goods manufactured based on the variable costing method. It is the calculation of raw material costs, direct labor costs, variable factory overhead, in result of cost of production. And the next is concept of selling price. The selling price itself is the price obtained from the accumulation of all costs incurred by the company to produce a product plus the percentage of expected profit. In its determination, there are several factors that influence the selling price decision-making policy. In general, according to Fendi, there are two main factors, namely internal factors and external factors that need to be considered. The first one is internal factors, or within the company itself. There are marketing objectives, marketing mix strategy, cost and organization. And the second is external factor or outside the company. There are the nature of the market and demand, the competition, and the other external elements. And the last is theoretical framework. This picture shows the theoretical framework from my research. The next capture is the research method. The definition of research method, according to Sugiono, the research method is a scientific way to obtain data with certain goals and uses. This step aims so that the data can be described, proven, developed, and understood in solving the problem that is the subject of discussion. The classification of data. According to Sugiono, this research method is a scientific way to obtain data with certain goals and use. This step aims so that the data can be described, proven, developed, and understood in solving the problem that is the subject of the discussion itself. The classification, including the first, data based on source, which are based on the source, the data are grouped into primary data. Primary data obtained in the study, including production costs and the calculation of cost of production applied by CV Mitra Dunia Palitindo. The secondary data used in the study, such as company history, vision and mission, organizational structure, and types of products produced by CV Mitra Dunia Palitindo. The second is data based on characteristic. Data according to its nature is divided into two, namely qualitative data. The qualitative data used in this research is an overview of CV Mitra Dunia Palitindo in the form of history, vision and mission, organizational structure, and business activities carried out. The second is quantitative data. Quantitative data in this study include raw material costs, direct labor costs, and factory overhead costs of CV Mitra Dunia Palitindo. Next is data collection techniques. Data collection techniques carried out during the study were, the first is observation. The thing that needs to be observed in the production process of box furniture, box garments, and box accessories at CV Mitra Dunia Palitindo is the observation activities will start from April to June 2022. Second, the interview. These techniques was used by researchers to find out the cost components involved in box production activities at CV Mitra Dunia Palitindo in more detail. Third, the documentation. The documentation contains company primary data, such as data on raw materials, costs, direct labor costs, and factory overhead costs of CV Mitra Dunia Palitindo. Next, data analysis techniques. The quantitative descriptive analysis technique is the analytical technique used in the study, namely the full costing method of calculating the cost of production. The result of the analysis will later be used as recommendation for determining the company's cost of good manufacture. And last is the schedule of activities. It is a list of a name of activity that will be held from April to June 2022, from the research permit application until the final project print. And the last is the bibliography. They are Dunia Firdaus Ahmad and Wasila Abdullah, akuntansi biaya, Bustami Bastianur Lela, akuntansi biaya, Cipto Novandi, Sajaji Pemasaran Jasa Prinsip Penerapan dan Penelitian, Hansen Dr. N. Marian M. Mowen, akuntansi manajemen, Mulyadi, akuntansi biaya, Rizdiana Ratna, analisis harga pokok produksi berdasarkan metode full costing sebagai dasar penentuan harga jual, Salman Kausariza, akuntansi biaya pendekatan produk costing, Setiani Ari Elinda, perhitungan harga pokok produksi dan harga menggunakan metode full costing pada home industri Fania Bakery di Semarang, Sugiono, metode penelitian bisnis pendekatan kuantitatif, kualitatif, dan R&D, Sutama, metode penelitian pendidikan kuantitatif, kualitatif, PTK, dan R&D, dan yang endless, Widoyoko Eko Putro, teknik penyusunan instrumen penelitian. Thank you. I think it's enough from me. Thank you for the attention. I'm so sorry if there are many mistakes. Wassalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.